looks clean.
And then go to the front so we can get off of the roof. It takes so long for the depth finder to work while it gets cocked up. Gently set it in. Okay, let her rip. I'm gonna set your move right up here, Brad. Just pull this first. Strip it out. Do that. And get ready, Johnny, to get that pot on the grass so you can. Make sure that's full it. Okay, Johnny, you gotta get the pot. Yeah. I pulled them all day long. I was tired. Yeah. See, there's an arrow. Should be getting there. Oh shit, we got the guy's pot. Not bad. Not bad at all. Oh my God. Okay. Oh Jesus. Okay. So preparing these hook canal spot prawns that I caught myself last weekend at hook canal. The recipe I'm going to be making I learned from my friend Mark Denniston, and this is his recipe for grilled hook canal spot prawns in a chili pepper sauce. So I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll get to the ingredients. All right, so we're going to go through the ingredients. It's pretty much the same. I did a couple of tweaks to make it my own, but it's the same idea, kind of like a chili pepper oil shrimp recipe. So we've got 3 to 4 cloves of chopped garlic or minced garlic, 2 teaspoons of smoked paprika. I have a tablespoon of regular paprika and a teaspoon of chili flakes, just regular old chili flakes. and this is where it gets a little bit different. I have a tablespoon of Korean chili flakes and a tablespoon of soy sauce, and then salt and pepper. And then right here, I also have some cayenne pepper and a little bit of MSG. So that's not traditional, but that's what I'm using. And he normally puts in chives, but I don't have any, so I'm not gonna put any of that in, but feel free to put in some chives if you want to make it look pretty. Oh, and we're also gonna use some Greek olive oil to bind it all together. You wanna remember, you know, you don't wanna put any acid in this, like white wine or lemon juice or lime juice, because it's gonna cook the shrimp. These Johneboukalis shrimp are very delicate. So if you wanna make ceviche, that would be a really good use for them too. But for this application, you don't want any acid involved. Okay, so in a bowl, I'm gonna do about a half cup of Greek olive oil. You can use whatever oil you want. I think olive oil gives a good flavor. I'm gonna throw in my chopped garlic, cayenne pepper and MSG, regular paprika and chili flakes. Then we have our regular paprika, or whatever one that was, one of the paprikas. Korean chili flakes, soy sauce, and I'm just gonna mix that all together. Another thing I really like to do is, after I marinate the shrimp in this for a couple of hours, I like to bring this up to a boil on the stove, and it makes a really, really good dipping sauce, really good hot oil dipping sauce. It kind of reminds me of like a Chinese hot oil. It's really, really good. All right, got that. Now I'm gonna add in the shrimp. And these shrimp, they are, I mean, I don't know, probably 20 to the pound, something like that. And I'm gonna toss this around with my freakishly long tasting spoon. This is probably not the best pencil for this, but I wanted to use it, so that's what I'm using. Now once these are all coated, I'm going to cover this, put it in the fridge for 2 hours or so. You could do longer if you want. And then I'm gonna skewer them and put them on the grill, so I'll be back. So I mean, it's pretty simple. What I'm gonna do is skewer the shrimp, just like this. I like to put them all the same direction, and I like to make sure it goes through, you know, both sides of the shrimp, two pieces of the shrimp, through the meaty part and then through the tail. There you go. So I'm gonna continue doing this until they're all done. And in the meantime, I'm gonna tell you guys a true life story that happened to me the other day. I was showing a house to some clients, and there was a big detached garage out there. And I show them the house, and I'm like, okay, let's go check out the garage. We go back to check out the garage, it's unlocked. There's not even a place to put the key, it's just a hole in the lock. So I'm like, okay, whatever. Open the door, pitch black in there. I turn on my cell phone camera light, because I can't find the light switch, and there's just a big red truck in there with a canopy on it. And I'm walking past it, and I look through the back window of the truck into the canopy, and there's a person sitting in the back of the truck with their shoulder against the back window. And they didn't move or anything. It was just a person's shoulder. You know, they're just hiding back there, hidden in the dark. And I just got freaked out and I ran out of there. My clients didn't really care though. They were kind of laughing at me like, oh, he's scared, haha. But so I talked to the other agent, and they said it was the groundskeeper who may have gotten a little spooked that we showed up and he wasn't ready for us. So he decided to hide in the dark in the garage. So I don't know, but luckily, we didn't get murdered, everything worked out okay. But you definitely do see some creepy things sometimes. Well, that was the creepiest thing I've seen, so. All right, close that out, 2 minutes. This is only like 1 minute in. So they go quick. We want them to be kind of charred. The
shells are going to protect the meat, and it gives a nice, you know, we want to get that smoke flavor. So
these are done. Camera cord's in the way. Finished product. There's my dipping sauce, served with a little bit of lime, and I'm just going to squeeze this lime all over it. There you go. All done. Time to taste. I got my little Japanese plate, and try these shrimp. They have a different texture than like Gulf shrimp or regular shrimp that you're used to. They kind of taste like lobster or have that texture, a more meaty texture. All right. I'm gonna dip it in this hot oil that I made. This is the marinade. Can you see that? Dip this in here. All right, here we go. That is so good. I swear that's some of the best shrimp I've ever had. It's so good. It tastes like lobster. So if you guys ever get a chance to get some hook canal or just Washington State, whatever spot prawns, I don't really know. There's probably other kinds. Make sure you try them. And I only go shrimping once a year. It's usually in May, but due to COVID, it was pushed back until July. Or June, July. But yeah, so good and so worth it. Holy. All right, well, that's it for this one. Hope you guys liked it. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video.
Might go into a dead period, maybe, when the tide...
Ah!